Hello everyone, and welcome back to the third video on whole slide image registration. At the end of the previous video, we ended up with a registered transfer with a transformation that registered the DAB image to the fluorescent image, and now this has been saved automatically inside our QuPath project, and now we can use that in order to transfer annotations from one image to the other. So let's go ahead and create some annotations and detections on this image. Define an area of interest here that I want to draw the cells from. And because it's nice to use fancy tools, we're going to use Stardist for the detection of these cells. So I have a script that allows me to run Stardist on the DAB image using the H and E heavy augment. There. So now we have some fairly good detections, not excellent, but fairly good. And we want to transfer these onto the fluorescent image. And all I need to do is switch to the fluorescent image, go to the tutorial here where we were before, and now all the way at the bottom of the page, there is the script that we can use to transfer the objects. So we're going to copy this to QuPath, and I'm going to make it into a new script here. So let's go through what this does a little bit. So we take the currently open project entry, which is, let's say, the image. We use this Warpy class, which is something we've written as an extension for QuPath, that allows us to get any other images in the project that can be transformed into this target. In the case that there are many, we have to select one. So here I select the first one. In our case, it doesn't change much. There is only one other image. From there, we can request the actual transformation that allows us to go from the source, so the image we're interested in, to the target, which is the image we are opening now. Then we can decide to pick up all of the objects that are currently on the source image, so the DAB. And finally, we can transform all these objects using the transform that we picked up on line 15 here. And then we add a convenience method that allows us to, on top of transferring the objects with all the measurements, add intensity measurements again to the newly transferred objects. Then the rest is more housekeeping. We add the objects to the scene and we make sure to update the GUI. And what that looks like from here, so you'll notice that my fluorescent image has no detections. And if I run it, you'll see now that it's transferred the DAB image onto the fluorescent image. On top of that, if I close my script, we can see that every single one of these cells contains the statistics from the DAB image and now also the statistics for channel 1 and channel 2. We can visualize this by using a measurement map and, for example, trying to visualize what the DAB mean looks like in our images and seeing by eye whether these correlate with the channel 2 intensities that we see on the fluorescent image. So let's just do that. DAB mean, can display them like this, add a bit of transparency. And we can see, to some extent, that will depend on the accuracy of the detection, of course, but we can see that where the DAB signal is high, there is also red signal. Now, we can also do this backwards, meaning I can delete all the objects on this image and draw out another region to analyze, let's say this one, for which I will also run a cell detection. Here I'm modifying the script so that it will work on fluorescence. Here the cells have been detected. And now what we want to do is transfer these detections back onto the DAB image. So I'll save these changes here. And now on the DAB image, I will run exactly the same script. There's nothing else to do. And we see now that these annotations have been found and have been transferred correctly. And we get a really nice cellular level resolution if our registration was done correctly. So that is it for us. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to go to the forum.imagesc and ask your questions there. Follow the tutorial that has been written here on C4Science. And we hope that this tool will be of use to you.